Hello my dear student, welcome to the class once again. So today we'll be discussing chapter 6. The name of the chapter is triangles, okay? So you are familiar with this chapter, you have read about many things about this chapter in class 9. Okay, the basic thing, whatever the things are required, you have read there. So we'll do the important things, whatever it is there in the chapter. Okay, let me directly go to exercise 6.1, because there is nothing in the first exercise. Okay, so let me go to exercise 6.1. If you see, there are some fill in the blanks, let me solve them for you. And then I will go to the main part, that is, it will start from the exercise 6.2. So you see, fill in the blanks using the correct words given in the bracket. So I think you know, all of you know the answer of this thing. All circles are two options are given, congruent or similar. Circles are similar, okay? So first one will be similar, then second one, all squares are, yes, all squares are also similar, not congruent, okay? Then Roman number 3, all dashed triangles are similar. So isosceles, it will have only two sides, so it will be equilateral triangle. Then Roman number 4, two polygons of the same number of sides are similar, their corresponding angles are, angles will be equal, their corresponding angles will be equal, and their corresponding sides are proportional, and the sides remains proportional. Okay, so it is there in your first exercise. What we have done, just you have to find, this is a very easy exercise, okay? And you just keep in mind this thing, the circles are similar, square also similar. In case of equilateral triangle, you will find that it is a similar, okay? Then in case of polygons, their corresponding angles will be equal to one another and their sides will be proportional, okay? Then question number 2, you see, give two different examples of a pair of similar figure. So this is also easy. You are just to give some example, you know this thing. First one, okay, I am just giving you some answer. Similar figure given, no? So one, you can write circles of different radii. Circles of different radii. And another one, so just now we have wrote about equilateral triangle, so you can write this one also, equilateral triangle of different edges. Okay, so these are the two examples. First one is a circle of different radii, this one will be also similar figure, and equilateral triangles of different edges, this one will also be the length of the edges may be different, but both of them will be always similar, okay? Then another one given, non-similar figure, rectangle and rhombus, you can write. Rectangle and rhombus are non-similar. Rectangle and rhombus. Another one, any two shape you take. Another one, circle and square, but square and circle, they are non-similar. One is round, another one has some edges, then sides, this thing, okay? So question number 3, state whether the following quadrilaterals are similar or not. You are to state that these quadrilaterals are similar or not. Two quadrilaterals you give, it is given in the question, you see PQRS and another one ABCD. Now they are not similar because you see one is a square, another one is a rhombus. Okay, and square and rhombus, their angles are also not similar. One has 90 degree angles, another has different measures in case of rhombus. So it will be, answer will be no. What is given, that whether the following quadrilaterals are similar or not. So you write not similar. Similar is, corresponding angles are not equal. Corresponding angles are not equal. If the angles were equal, then we could have said, but here the angles are not equal, so we cannot say that they are similar. So now let us move to the next exercise, that is exercise 6.2. But before that, we need to know some theorems. Okay, very important theorems are there. So similarity of a triangle, this exercise is about similarity of a triangles. How can the two triangles be similar? Okay, so two triangles are similar if their corresponding sides are equal. If their corresponding sides are equal or corresponding sides are in the same ratio or in proportion, okay, their corresponding sides are equal or their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. The ratio of any two corresponding sides in two equilateral triangle is always the same, which is known as the basic proportionality theorem or the Thales theorem. So first one, theorem 6.1, which we can say as a basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem. So very important theorem for exam point of view, and it often comes also. We can say it as this theorem is also known as the Thales theorem or basic proportionality theorem. Theorem 6.1. What is given here? If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. Okay. So given like this, if a triangle, okay, let me draw it nicely. It is given like this, that if a line is drawn, if I have drawn a line parallel to this line BC, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of the triangle, so you can see DE is parallel, we have drawn DE parallel to BC of a triangle to intersect the other two sides, it is intersecting the other two sides at D and E, okay, in distinct points. Yes, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. The other two sides are divided in the same ratio. That means you have to prove that AD by BD will be equals to AE by EC. AD by DB, okay, you write it like this, AD by DB, AD DB will be equals to AE by EC. So you have to prove that. That means the ratio remains, the ratio of these two sides will be equals to that other two sides, okay. So you have to prove this one. This is the basic proportionality theorem or the Thales theorem, okay. So first of all, you write the theorem nicely. I am not writing it here, you write it, okay. If a line is drawn, very important, if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio, okay. I will solve this one. You write the theorem nicely. So first of all, proof, what is okay, let me start. Given, I am doing the solution part. Given a triangle ABC, in which a line parallel to the side BC, in which a line parallel, I am directly writing from the book, okay, parallel to side BC intersect other two sides, intersect other two sides AB and AC at D and E respectively, okay. Given a triangle ABC in which a line parallel to side BC, we are talking about DE, okay, intersect the other two sides AB and AC, at D and E respectively, okay. So to prove, we have to prove AD by DB is equals to AE by
EC. We have to prove this one.
Okay.
So for that we need a construction part also. So construction, you write. You see here by dotted line it is given. Some perpendiculars are drawn. M, N.
M and okay. So this is the construction part. So what is given? You write like this: join BE and CD.
Join BE and CD. BE which one? BE and CD.
And then draw
this one. So we know I have written in the there also which one we have to prove.
So join BE and CD, then draw DM perpendicular to, now we have drawn DM perpendicular to AC and EN perpendicular to AB.
DM perpendicular to AC, AC and EN perpendicular to AB. EN perpendicular to AB. So this has also some reason for which we have drawn this perpendicular, because you will find the area of the triangles, and in case of area of the triangle, while finding we need the altitude, so half into base into altitude. So this will be our altitude because these are perpendiculars. Okay. So now proof part, up to this much it is okay. So now I am erasing this one. Now we'll write the proof.
So you write area of what is given? Area of triangle. First of all, which one they are finding? Area of triangle ADB. So area of triangle we can write
ADE.
Area of triangle ADE equals to half into base into altitude.
ADE which one? ADE. That means this one. So it will be half into base. One time we'll take base this one. Another time we'll take base
that one.
At perpendicular, so if I take base this one, this will be the perpendicular, that is the height. If I take base this one, this will be the
height. So half into base into altitude, that means half into AD into EN. Half into AD into EN.
So equation number one. Then one by one, let us find area of triangle BDE.
Area of triangle BDE
equals to ADE, then they are finding
BDE, no?
Okay, let me find in pair because we will divide 1 by 2, 2 by 3 like this. So, it will be okay. Let us find first of all one side, this one, then that side, okay? So, then again BDE, this triangle, okay? So, for this triangle also height will be this one. So, half into
height will be
this EN, okay?
So, half into
DB into EN, DB is the base into EN. What we have done? First of all, actually we are completing one side. First of all, we have taken this triangle. Now we are taking this one. Okay. This one, these are the things left. We are not going for this thing. First of all, I have taken this triangle here. EN was the perpendicular. Then I have taken this one D, B and E. They are also this perpendicular, so it will be same. The height of the triangle, it will be same. So we have taken this one, it is the height of this whole triangle, so it is this one, so it will be EN will be same, so it will be half into DB into
EN.
Now we will go to this side. So first of all we will find this one, then I will find this side triangle, okay,
same similarly, okay.
So similarly I will find, similarly area of triangle,
so they are giving directly, you can write it, no problem.
Area of triangle BDE.
Area of triangle BDE.
You can write it like this also. If you don't give this sign also, no problem.
Area of triangle BDE.
All are similar. From there it starts. only first of all we have drawn this one,
then we have started from here.
So similarly then this one comes area of triangle
BDE we have done, then area of triangle ADE.
For ADE also it will be same, half into, now we are taking this one ADE, ADE, that means now I'll take base as this one, so DM will be the perpendicular,
okay,
DM will be the height, okay, so half into, and base will be AE, so half into AE into DM, equation number 3, and area of triangle EDC or what is given here DEC, same thing, DEC will be equals to half into DM, height will be same and base will be EC, base will be EC. So we have got four area, first of all we have taken this one and that one, then we have taken this one and that one, first of all we have taken this one and this one whole, then again this one whole and that triangle, okay. So we have got four area, now what we will do, we will divide this one by that one and this one by this one, so they are dividing, let me write, dividing 1 by 2, dividing 1 and 2 we get, dividing 1 and 2 we get area of triangle ADE by area of triangle, which one, 2, BDE, very carefully you write this thing or you may do error, there what is it, half into AD into EN, half into AD into EN, and there what is it, half into DB into EN, okay, this is our first area, first area it is half into AD into EN, so half half cancel, EN EN cancel, which one left, AD by DB, so you write there AD by DB, so from first one what we have got, okay, there is no space, so you write there below, I am writing here, it came AD by DB, AD by DB, give it as equation number 5. Again what I will do, I will divide 3 and 4, so after dividing triangle, this area of triangle ADE by BDE, we have got AD by DB, because half half cancel, EN EN cancel, AD and DB left. So similarly in the same way I will divide these two, okay, so I am erasing this part, so there, and again dividing 3 and 4 we get, but 3 by 4 you get, write it, same thing, area of which one, this one ADE by area of DEC, ADE by DEC will be equals to what is it, half AE DM, half AE DM, half EC DM, okay, so 3 and 4 we have got this one, so if I cancel, half half cancel, DM DM cancel, it came AE by AC, which is our equation number 6, so after that only 2-3 lines left, okay, up to this much it is clear, first of all I have taken the area 1 by 1, now I am dividing 1 by 2 and 3 by 4, so after dividing, actually I am taking this side, so this side when I took, this one divided by that one, when I have taken this one, so this one divided by that one, so I have got for this one, I have got AD by DB, it is which I have given as equation number 5, and this one I have given as 6, so after that only 1 or 2 line left, okay. Now you see, this is the value for this one AD by DB, and this is the value for this one AE by AC, so now you see what is given here, triangle BDE and triangle DEC, these two triangle if you see they are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, that means their area will be same. If two parallel lines are there and two triangles are drawn on the same base, okay, their area is always the same, their area always remains the same. If they are between the same parallel line and on the same base, then the area remains the same. So you write now
but since you give now not it will be work better
since triangle BDE which one this one triangle BDE and triangle this one are on the same base DE triangle BDE and triangle DEC are on the same base I am not erasing this one because I need this one okay somehow let me write so triangle BDE and triangle DEC are on the same base DE and between the same parallel also and between the same parallel and between the same parallel and between the same parallels BC and DE you see very carefully here what I have written here that this triangle this one this triangle okay and that triangle these two triangles are on the same base DE and between the same parallel lines BC and DE are parallel okay BC and DE are in if you read the question very carefully you can see it is given that a parallel line is drawn so DC and BC and DE are parallel so they are between the same parallel and the same base so there is a theorem like this that if two triangles are on the same base and between the same parallels then their area remains the same so I can say that therefore area of triangle BDE is equals to area of triangle DEC okay let me erase this is there in the book from there I can write it is becoming too much congested no so I can write area of triangle BDE will be equals to area of triangle DEC are you getting my words what I have said that if the two triangles are on the same base and between the same parallel then their area remains the same that means area of this triangle and that triangle will be same so if these two are same so you see very carefully what I have written from two equation if I relate okay let me erase this one you see in the book after dividing what we have got area of these two triangle ADE by BDE page number 149 you see area of triangle ADE by BDE we have got AD by DB area of triangle ADE by DEC we have got AE by EC and just now we have got that BDE and DEC are same if BDE and DEC are same here you see very carefully one what we have got okay let me write and then I will explain so hence area of triangle you write like this area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE will be equals to area of triangle ADE by area of triangle DEC you say very carefully why I have written this one because just now we have solved that this one and this one both of them have the same area so that means you see the numerator to it is same denominator only is only different and just now we have got they are same so if these two are also same these two though we can see these are same and these two also just now we have proved that they are same so I can write that both of them are equal so if both of them are equal then what is the value of AR by area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BD it is AD by DB AD by DB we have proved earlier you see and there it is AD by DE is equal to AE by EC so proved okay first of all we have found the area one by one then what we have done I have shown that these two area is same acha before that what we have done we have divided equation 1 by 2 equation 3 by 4 equation 1 we have taken which are on the same side okay equation 2 I have taken this triangle this one and that one they are on the same side I have divided them I have got the two ratio like this AD by BD is equals to this one and this one equals to that one
Now after that, what do you have shown? I have shown that these two triangles are equal. Sorry, these two area of these two triangles are equal. If area is same, then I can write like this that this one and this one also same. This part to okay. This one and this one it is same. That means both this ratio it is same. So I can write AD by DB equals to AE by EC. So this is the basic proportionality theorem or the Thales theorem. Okay, in exam it may come very important. Now let us move to theorem 6.2, the converse of this theorem. Now you have to prove that if the ratio is same, then you have to prove that the lines, this line and that line, it is parallel. Okay, same theorem, just opposite you have to prove. Earlier the line was parallel and question was given that you have to prove that the ratio is same. Now it is given the ratio is same, but you have to prove that theorem 6.2 it is given. You see in your book, you write this theorem nicely and then you solve. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the lines is then the line is parallel to the third side. So what is there? Earlier I have it was given in the question, the triangle was given, parallel line was given, it was intersecting the sides. The question was to prove that they are in the same ratio. You have to prove that whatever the line they have intersected, the ratios are same. Now what is given? The ratio is given same, and you have to prove that the line is parallel. That means the converse of the earlier theorem. So first of all, let me draw a line D, but I will not take this one. Okay, I will not take this one as parallel. By seeing, so I can see that it is parallel, but we'll assume that it is not parallel. I will take another line somewhere like this, and this one I will take that yes, this is parallel. What we'll do? We'll take by seeing, so I can see that yes, this one and this one parallel. But question is given to prove. So first of all, what I'll do? I'll take that these two lines are not parallel. DE and DE dash and BC are parallel. We'll take, and then we'll prove that these two lines are same. So we can say that DE will be parallel to BC. This is not that much lengthy. So you write like this, given theorem you write, okay. There is no, it will take space, so I am not writing. So given a triangle ABC, given a triangle ABC, B, and this one you mark as the line L. So given a triangle, so one thing you do, let me give it as F, let it be like this, EF, EE dash, sometime we may write also, error may be also there while giving the dash, if you don't give then it will be wrong. So you write it as F, okay. So a triangle ABC and a line L intersecting, so it is given, and a line L, and a line L intersecting AB at which point? AB at D. Given a triangle ABC and a line L intersecting AB at D and AC at, and AC at which two points? AC in at E. Okay. So it is given in the question that a line is there and these two, we have to prove that DE is parallel to BC. So a line is there and it is intersecting this line at point D and this line at point this side at point E, and ratio is also given equal. So let me write, the ratio is given such that you write such that AD by DB it is given equals to AE by AC. It is given in the question, the ratios are same. Okay, so you have to prove that lines are parallel. Now the opposite one, to prove that DE is parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. Now you have to prove that BE is parallel to DE is parallel to BC. So this will be our construction, okay? Okay. So we'll take this one. So up to this much it is okay. Now I erase and let me start writing from the first. So I am erasing this part. Now I'll do the proof part. Because I need space, and if I can write it in the same, then it will be easy for you to understand also. So you see, proof I am doing now. So first of all, we'll let that DE is not parallel to BC. So if this one, this line is not parallel to that line, that means there should be any other line which is parallel to this one. We'll take that this line is not parallel to that one. So if it is not parallel, that means there must be any other line which is parallel. So we'll take DF as that line, okay? So if possible, let DE is not parallel to BC. Let DE is not parallel. DE is not parallel to BC. If possible, let DE is not parallel to BC, then there must be another line. Then there must be another line. Then there must be another line through D parallel to BC. Then there must be another line through D parallel to BC. So we'll take that line as DF, okay? So let DF be parallel to BC. We are taking DF as a parallel line. So if this one is not parallel, that means the another line it is there somewhere in this triangle which is intersecting the both sides and it is parallel to BC. So let us take DF as that line. So let DF is parallel to BC. So by basic proportionality theorem, okay? Then by basic proportionality theorem, we have AD by DB will be equals to AF by FC. AD, if this line is parallel, that means basic proportionality theorem will work. AD by DB will be equals to AF by FC. So I can write, we have AD by DB equals to AF by FC. Okay. AF by FC. So this one is our equation number one. This is our equation number one. Not that much difficult, okay? Two, three lines are there. Let me write, you will understand. So I have used basic proportionality theorem here. That means ratio of this side and that side will be equals to AF by EC. This side by that side will be equals to this side by this one. But earlier what we have written, we have shown that AD by DB is equals to AE by EC. AE by EC. While writing the given part, it was given in the question, you see. When I have written given, that time I have written this one. So it will be our equation number 2. AD by DB will be equals to AE by CE. AE by EC. So from 1 and 2 I can write AD by DB is common for both. That means AE by EC will be equals to AF by FC. So from 1 and 2, we have AE by, let me write AF. AF by FC will be equals to AE by EC. AF by FC will be equals to AE by EC. AF by FC will be equals to AE by EC. So what I'll do, adding in both side I am adding 1. In this exercise you will find this like this way maximum sums are done. Okay, so plus 1, adding 1 on both sides. If you want, you can write adding 1 on both sides. Actually, there is a reason of adding 1. So if I add 1, then it will be, if I take the LCM, FC will be there, AF plus FC will be there, equals to, and there AE plus EC will be there by EC. Is it okay? AF plus FC. Now AF plus FC will be equals to AC, and this one AE plus EC, AE plus EC also will be equals to AC. Okay, so so I can write it as AC by FC, and that side also AE plus EC equals to AC by EC, AC by EC. Now you see, if I compare, if I compare this side, AE, AC, they are also in numerator, in this side also it is there, that side also it is there. So if these two are equal, if I compare the numerator and the denominator, so AC is equals to AC, that means FC will be equals to EC, FC will be equals to EC. So from this one I can write AC is equals to AC. So if I cancel it, that's the same thing, but no need to cancel. Okay, this one and this one, it is equal, that means FC will be equals to, FC will be equals to EC. And if FC and EC are same, if FC and EC are same, that means they are coinciding. If FC and EC are same, you see the length very carefully. If they are different, then what will happen? You see the distance, they are not same. Is the same? FC and EC, distance, there are some differences there. So if they are same, that means they are on the same point. That means E and F, it is on the same point. They are coinciding. Okay. So we can say that since FC and EC are same, that means that is E and F coincides. That is E and F. Okay, if FC is equals to EC, that means they must be the same point only, then only it is possible. If I draw a side like this, there I have given F, there I have given E, and there I have given C. So FC and EC will be same only if and only if they are the same point. They are the same point, that means both of them lie on the same. Okay, so that is E and F coincide. So if E and F coincides, then DF is the line, DF is the line L itself. So that means if these two points coincide, that means DF is the line L itself. Therefore, yes, DF is the line itself. DF is the line L itself. Okay, DF is the line L itself. If they are on the same point, if they are the same, that means they lie on the same line L. So that means DF is the line L itself. So if DF is the line L itself, then I can say hence DF, that means DE is parallel to BC, because earlier we have shown that let DF be parallel to BC. So if DF and DE are the same line, that means DE is parallel to BC, proved. And this trick now we are going to use many a time, plus 1 1. Okay, both side adding plus 1, then we are solving. So these two theorem you practice very nicely. Okay, first one, and this is the converse of the theorem, first one. Okay, basic proportionality theorem. Now example number 1, let me discuss, then I will go to the exercise, and later on I will discuss the other example, because example number 1 also you need while solving the, what is the proof done here, this one also you need while solving the sum. So later on it will be easy for me to relate the things. So I am doing example number 1 first. Example number 1 also you can take as a kind of theorem. because this proof also we need in sum. Okay, so if a line same like this given, D is a point, you see in the book, I'll not do the whole one, I'll just go on solving the whole part. Okay, so if a line intersect AB and AC of triangle ABC at D and D respectively, and is parallel, so this line is parallel to this one. So we know basic proportion theorem, it is AD by DB equals to AE by EC, but here you have to prove that, you see, AD by the whole side AB and AE by the whole side AC. So you have to prove this one. So solution will start, I'll just show you the solve. DE is parallel to in exam you write given and then you write this thing. Okay, DE is parallel to BC. If DE is parallel to BC, then by basic proportionality theorem, you write it full. By basic proportionality theorem, I can write AD by this one is D, AD by DB will be equals to AE by EC.
Okay, AE by DB will be equals to AE by EC.
So let me make it a reciprocal. Let me write DB here. DB by AD will be equals to EC by A, just I am doing the reciprocal. Okay, so DB came here, AD came here, EC came, got there, AE came here, reciprocal of this line. So now let me add plus 1, DB by AD plus 1 equals to EC by AE plus 1. Okay, and you write adding plus 1 on both sides. So DB by AD, if I add, then it will be DB plus AD by AD. There it will be EC plus AE by AE. So DB plus AD.
So DB plus AD.
It is DB plus, you see, DB plus AD. AD. Actually, why I have done the reciprocal? If I do normally, answer will come, but the base will be that time, it will be DB every time. But what do I need? I need this one, AB and AC below, AD and AE should be there. Later on again I will reciprocal. If I do the same and if I just add there plus 1, you will not be able to match the answer. Okay. So first of all, we have to do the reciprocal, then you have to add. So DB plus AD, it is AB itself. And there it is EC plus AE equals to EC plus AE will be equals to AC by AE. Now again you do the reciprocal, this answer will come. You see AB by AD equals to AC by AE. So now if I do the reciprocal, it will be AD by AB will be equals to AE by AC. Okay, this is your answer, AD by AB equals to AE by EC. To keep this one same, I have done the reciprocal at first. Okay, if you just keep the same and if you go on adding, you will not be able to match the answer. Later on you will get confused, because this one will not match, AB will not come here. If I keep the same, then this one, DB and EC will be there below. Okay, so example 2 and 3 later on I will solve. Let us move to exercise 6.2, and this one you keep in mind, we can write AD by AB. Just now we have proved, I can write AD by AB will be equals to AE by AC. Okay, if needed in some mess, then we can use this one. Okay, now it's exercise 6.2, question number 1, you see. Question number 1, in the figure 1 and 2, DE is parallel to BC. If EC is equals to 1, find EC in equation 1. So, it's a very easy thing, you just see here. DE is given A, B, C it is given. This one 1.5, this one 1 centimeter, you need to give. There it is 3 centimeter. Question is to find EC. So by basic proportionality theorem, I can write AD by
db will be equals to ae by ec. So what is ad here? It is 1.5. what is ab here? 3. what is ae here? 1. ec it will be same. I have to find this one. So 3, if I cancel 1.5, okay, so 1.5 2s are 3, okay, and 2 1s are 2, so ec is equals to 2 centimeter. ec is equals to 2 centimeter. Then next one, this one was Roman number 1. Roman number 2 also, it is given something like that. D, E, they are A, they are B, they are C. This is 7.2 centimeter. This one 1.8 centimeter. This one 5.4 centimeter. I have to find AD. I have to find AD. So again, by basic proportionality theorem, you write it full. Don't write BPT, okay? Basic proportionality theorem you write, and then you write what is the formula. AD by DB will be equals to AE by EC. AD, which one? It is not there. So AD it will be same. There it is 7.2. There AE it is 1.8. There 5.4. So 18 threes are 54. So that means it will be 0.3. Okay. So AD will be equals to 7.2 by 0.3. So if I remove the decimal, it will be 72 by 3. Okay. One place decimal, so I can remove. So 3. decimal will not be there, so it will be 3 by 7.2. so if I cancel it, it will be 2.4 centimeter, because 18 threes are 54, so 1.8 threes are 5.4, so it will be like this. Okay, so AD will be equals to 2.4 centimeter. Now question number 2, you see, so question number 2, you see, so E and E for the points on the, yes, EFE, what is given here? E and F are points on the side PQ and PR respectively of a triangle PQR. For each of the following case, state whether EF is parallel to QR or not. EF is parallel to QR or not. So very easily we can prove. Just if we can say that this basic proportionality theorem it is not following, then we can say that. So what was the theorem? We know that if a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Okay, so using this one we will find it. If they divide the line in the same ratio like this, if the ratio comes same for both one, that is AD by AE, if it comes for the both for the same one, then we can say that. So PQR is a triangle given. Let me draw PQR, and it is given that EF is parallel to QR. So first one, you see, question number 2, Roman number 1, what is given? PE given 3.9, PE given 3.9, then EQ given 3 centimeter, then PF given 3.6 and FR given 2.4. so everything it is given. You have to check if the ratio comes same for both one, then I can say that yes, they are parallel. So here one by one let me find. Here PE by EQ equals to 3.9 by 3, okay, and another one, it is PF by FR equals to 3.6 by 2.4. so if I cancel with 3, then 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9, it will be 13.1 by 1, and there if I cancel, it will be 6 6 are 36 and 6 4 are 24.
again you can cancel it. 12, yes, 12 threes are 12, 2s are, okay. So 1 is coming 0.3 by 0.2, that means if I solve it, point point will be cancelled. Be 3 by 2 means I can write it as 3 by 2, and 3 by 2 means 1.5. So it is coming 1.5 by 1. So 1.5 by 1, and they are 1.3 by 1. So that means they are not matching. There the value came 1 by 1.3, and here the value came 1.5. So it is not same. So I can say that thus P by EQ is not parallel to, is not equal to PF by FR. Therefore, EF is not parallel to EY. Therefore, EF is not parallel to Q1. Okay. So first one finished. Then let me do Roman number 2. The value will be changed. Let me see whether it is parallel or not. Okay. So what are the values? Let me write 4, 4.5. P it is 4, then QE it is 4.5, then PF it is 8, and RF it is 9. Unit I am not writing it. So you see here PE by EQ it is 4 by 4.5, and there it is PF by FR it is 8 by 9. If I written correctly everything, PE by EQ it is 4 by 4.5 and PF by FR it is 8 by 9. Okay. Achha. One thing you see, this one to 4 by 4.5. I can convert this one to 4 by 4.5. 2 4s are 8. 2 4s are 8 and 2, if I divide 9, it will be 4.5. Are you getting? 2 4s are 8 and 2, if I divide 9, it will be 4.5. So both of them are equal. That means EF is parallel to QR. Okay. EF is parallel to QR. Roman number 3, you try by yourself. Okay. Check whether that this one is parallel to that one or not. If I go and do in the divide, this one will be parallel. Okay. You check this one. Roman number 3, it is parallel. You just try to find the answer. Only you divide the next one, you will get the answer. Now let us move to question number 3. Excuse me. You see the question number 3, it is so question number 3, you see what is given here, that 3 is 6.18, this is the figure. Let me draw the figure first of all, then I will explain the thing. These things are very easy. If you see one or two, no, you can very easily solve this thing. Just you have to use it, and very easy actually. You just see one or two sum, how to do. You can do any sum in exam. A, M, B, then this one C, this one L, this one N, this one D, okay. You see here, what is given? That in figure LM is parallel to, LM is parallel to CB and LN is parallel to CD. Okay. This line is parallel to this one, this line is parallel to this one. So first of all, I will take this upper triangle. If this line is parallel to this one, that means this one AM is AM divided by BM will be equals to AL divided by LC. Then again I will take this part, I will write AL divided by LC will be equals to AN divided by ND.
then I will find these two part common, then I can directly write AM by MB will be equals to AN by ND, proved. Okay, very easy. You see how I am doing. So solution in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, LM is parallel to BC. LM is parallel to BC, not if LM, then CB you write. Okay, LM is parallel to CB. So these two lines are parallel. If these two lines are parallel, then I can use the basic proportionality theorem. So by using basic, you write it full. Okay, let me write one time. Basic for me it takes too much space. No, you write it full in your copy. By using basic proportionality theorem, I can write AM by, okay, you see the you see the question actually. What you want to find? AM by AB, this one divided by that one actually. It is not directly the basic proportionality theorem, it is the converse of basic proportionality theorem. If you can remember example one, what I have done, that this one is equals to that one. So using this one, okay, it is also a basic proportionality theorem. Or if you want, you can write converse by using the converse of basic proportionality theorem. I can write, so let me write it like this, AM by the whole side AB, then for this one also it will be AL by the whole side AC, first equation, okay, AL by the whole side AC. Similarly, in triangle ACD, LN is parallel to CD, LN is parallel to CD. So using basic proportionality theorem, I can write this side AN by the whole side AD. So AN by AD will be equals to this one, AL by AC. Now if you see equation 1 and 2, this part is common for both. So from 1 and 2 directly I can write AM by AB equals to AN by AD, finished. So after that you write from equation 1 and 2 we get these two parts are equal. So I can write AM by AB equals to AN by AD, proved. Okay, finished. Very easy thing, just you have to see what you have to prove. Okay, if you need the basic proportion to be a direct one, then you use it, and there you are using the converse actually on you can see that one case of a basic proportionality theorem. It was like this, that in example one we have solved, no, AM is equals to AB. It's okay, you can write by using basic proportionality theorem. It is also a kind of this one. So we have proved that these two are equal. So now let us move to the next one. All are same actually, all will be like this, three line, two line, like this and finished. So question number 4, you see a triangle is given, this one also same, this is also important question. Okay, so what is there, you see DE is parallel to AC given. So by seeing also you can see DE is parallel to AC, and DF is parallel to AE, and DF is parallel to AE. So prove that BF by FE is equals to BE by AC. So first of all you have to relate them, then you have to find. So first of all let us write in triangle BCA solution, this one, okay, in triangle BCA, I am taking the whole one. In triangle BCA, what is given? DF is parallel to AC. DF is parallel to AC. It is given in the question. If DF is parallel to AC, then I can use basic proportionality theorem. By using basic proportionality theorem, you write it full. By using basic proportionality theorem, I can write what? These two, okay. What I have done, DF is parallel to AC. So let me erase this one. You can see nicely. Later on, I will give when I do the other one. So DF is parallel to AC. That means this side will be equals to this one, and this one will be equals to that one. Is it like this? So it will be B by EC. In triangle BCA, we have taken DE is parallel to AC. Sorry, not this one. DE is parallel to AC, not this point, okay. Sorry, actually, DE is parallel to AC, no? Oh, I have written at DF, that's why I got confused. So, DE is parallel to AC. So, if DE is parallel to AC, that means BE by EC will be equals to BD by DE. So, I can write BE by EC equals to BD by DA. So, this will be our first equation. Now, again, in triangle, but again, not it, now you give, now in triangle, which one we are taking? Another one, what is it? It's triangle BE and A. Now you are taking BE and A, so it is was like this. So that means this line, DF is parallel to this one. Now we are taking this line and this line parallel, okay. I have just erased the this whole one so that you can understand. If there is another line, you may get confused. So now this one is parallel to this one. So if these two are parallel, that means this one will be equal to this one, and there this one will be equal to that one, okay. So in triangle BEA, in triangle BEA, we have DF by, there also you write we have, it looks good. We have DF by, DF is parallel to AE. We have DF is parallel to AE. So if DF is parallel to AE, then I can write by using basic proportionality theorem. By using basic proportionality theorem, I can write BF by FE will be equals to BD by DA, okay. BF by FE equals to BD by DA. Now again, like earlier, you see this part and this part, it is common for both. So I can write BE by EC equals to BF by FC. So that will be the main which one you have to prove. So you see the question, BE by EC you have to prove equals to BF by FE. So now these two are equal, so I can write from 1 and 2 BE by EC will be equals to BF by FE. So from 1 and 2, we have, so BF by FE equals to BE by, so we have proved, okay. You can see BF by FE equals to BE by EC. No, FE, yes, FE. What have you written? BF by FE equals to BE by EC. Sorry, it is EC. So question number 4 finished. So now let us move to question number 5. So question number 5, it is same like this one. Here also it is given in figure, DE is parallel to OQ and DF is parallel to OR. Show that EF is parallel to QR.
So question number, this figure is given here. Let me draw it. P, Q, R, then their line came like this. Okay. There E, then D, then F, and from there it came like this. Oh, okay. This is the figure. Okay. So it is given that DE is parallel to OQ. DE is parallel to OQ. This line is parallel to this one, and DF is parallel to OR, and DF is parallel to OR. So no problem. We will use the basic proportionality theorem in this diagram very easily, same like earlier one. Okay. So in triangle PQO, first of all I will take this triangle, then I will take then triangle, and it will be finished. So question number 5, in solution, in triangle PQO we have DE is parallel to DE is given, no? Yes, DE is parallel to OQ. D is parallel to OQ. So if D is parallel to OQ, so I can use by basic proportionality theorem. By basic proportionality theorem, what you are to prove? You are to prove that EF is parallel to QR. EF is parallel to QR. Okay. EF is parallel to QR. So first, somehow I have to prove that PE. That means this one equals to that one, and this one equals to that one. I have to prove that this side is equals to this side, and this side is equals to that side. So if I can prove this thing, that the ratios are same, then I can say that these two lines are parallel. So somehow I have to relate them, and I have to show that. So easily it will be related. You see, by basic proportionality theorem, I can write PE by EQ will be equals to PD by OQ. Yes. This side will be equals to this one. You see very carefully, and this side will be equals to this one. This side will be equals to this one. That means PD will be equal, PD, sorry, PD divided by OQ, not equal. PD will be divided by DO. Equation number 1, PD by EQ equals to PD by DO. So similarly, by again in triangle, or now in triangle, the next one PQI have taken, so it will be PR, triangle PRO, DF is parallel to given, DF is parallel to given OR. So by BPT again I can write, by basic proportionality theorem I can write again like this, that PF by FR will be equals to PD by DO. So now from 1 and 2 you can see these two part is common, so I can write this one equals to this one. That means PE by EQ equals to PF by FR, and if these sides are proportional, so I can say that these two lines are also parallel. So finished, only one line. So from 1 and 2 we get, from 1 and 2 we get PE by EQ equals to PF by FR, and if the ratio is same, that means I can say that EF is parallel to QR. Okay. Because we are solving this one for so many times, no? That in the this second theorem, what we have showed, that if these two lines are parallel, in the first one, what we have showed, basic proportionality theorem, that the if these parts are in the second theorem, what we have proved, that if these ratios are same, that means the lines are parallel. So that means the ratios are same, so I can say that EF is parallel to QR, hence proved. So now let us move to question number 7. Using theorem 6.1, question number 6. In the figure, A, B, C are the points
OP, OQ and OR respectively such that AB is parallel to PQ, AC is parallel to PR, so that BC is parallel to QR. Okay,
no problem. The very easy. Same thing actually for each and every one. The what is the thing used? It is same. The way we are doing. Okay, we are solving exercise 6.2. So question number 6.
So question number 6, you see, figure is given like this. Okay, let me draw the figure first of all.
PQR is a triangle. Inside this one, the point O is there, and like this, some lines are given and named as A, B and C. Okay. So this is the figure.
So question is to show that BC is parallel to QR.
So they have said that AB is parallel to PQ, AC is parallel to this one. So you have to show that this line is parallel to that one.
So same like earlier one.
First of all, one time I will take these two lines as parallel. So I will prove that this part is equal to this one, this like this. Then again I will take this one. So after comparing, I will get that from this side it will come this one divided by this one equals to this one divided by that one. So
okay, let me solve, you will understand. Same like the earlier one, how we have done.
So solution given.
So given O is any point.
So O is a point given. So you write like this: O is any point within. O is any point within triangle PQR, within triangle PQR, and it is given that AB is parallel to PQ and AC is parallel to PR. So it is given in the question. Okay, and what we have to prove? To prove that BC is parallel to, okay, if you want you can write, or oh, no, it's okay, no need. So since you see here in triangle, let me write in triangle. First of all, let me take this one QOP or POQ, it's up to you. Okay, let me take it like this: OP in triangle OPQ. In triangle OPQ, you see very carefully, in triangle OPQ we have AB is parallel to PQ, AB is parallel to PQ. So if in triangle OPQ, let me draw it here, you can see very nicely, OPQ line is given parallel, that is AB. So if this line is parallel, that means the ratio OA by AP will be equals to OB by BQ. It will be like this. So by basic proportionality theorem, therefore by basic proportionality theorem, I can write OA by AP equals to OB by BQ. First equation. Okay, so similarly, okay, let me write it here. Now in triangle OPR we have AC is parallel to PR. AC is parallel to PR. So if AC is parallel to PR, then by basic proportionality theorem I can write again, what is here, that in triangle POR and this one given AC, no, so it will be again same, OA by AP will be equals to, in place of OB, now it will be OC by CR
equation 2. OA by AP equals to OC by CR. So now from 1 and 2 you see this part, it is common for both OA by OP. So I can write OB by BQ equals to OC by CR. So from 1 and 2, we get OB by BQ equals to OC by CR. So now you see one thing that you can understand very nicely. What we have shown here, OB, that means this side is this side by this side, the ratio of these two sides is equal to the ratio of these two sides. So if it is like this, that I can write this BC is parallel to QR, because basic proportionality theorem to we know in triangle, if I take OQR as a triangle and then this one divided by this one equals to this one divided by that one, the ratio is same, that means I can write BC is parallel to QR. So you write like this, thus in triangle OBR, in triangle OBR, BC are divided, B and C are divided, B and C are the points dividing which side? OQ and OR. Dividing the side OQ and OR. OQ and OR in the same ratio. So I can say that therefore this BC is parallel to QR. BC is parallel to QR. Since in triangle OBR, B and C are the points dividing the side OQ and OR in the same ratio, the ratio is same, so I can say that BC is parallel to QR. Okay. So now let us move to the next one. Question number 7, only 3 left after that. So question number 7, you see, using theorem 6.1, proved that the line drawn through the midpoints of one side of a triangle parallel to the another side, bisects the third side.
Okay.
Proved that the line drawn from the midpoint of one side of a triangle is parallel to the other side, bisects the third side. Okay.
Yes, it is. It will be like this: ABC, and you give as DA.
Question is to show that this line is by this line and this side are bisected. Okay. Proved that the line drawn from the midpoint of one side of a triangle, parallel to the other side, bisects the third side. So this line is drawn from the midpoint. So if it is drawn from the midpoint, then and it is parallel to BC, then this part also will be bisected equally. I have to prove that AE is equals to EC. Very easy. No problem is there. Question is given that this line is parallel to this one and D is the midpoint. Okay. So from midpoint, if I draw a line parallel to this one, then normally this one will also be the midpoint. So just I have to show that AE is equal to EC. Okay. So question number 7, you write like this. Triangle to not mentioned, no? So write, let ABC be a triangle. I am taking ABC as a triangle in which D is the midpoint, of which side? Of side AB. D is the midpoint of side AB. So D is the midpoint of side AB and the line and the line DE is drawn parallel to BC, and the line DE is drawn parallel to BC, and the line DE is parallel to BC meeting AC at E. Okay, so this is the thing which is what is given. So let we have drawn ABC be a triangle in which D is the midpoint of the side AB and the line DE is drawn parallel to BC meeting AC at E. So you write like this. So we have to prove that AE equals to EC. What is given here? Using the prove that. Okay, let me write. It will be easy to prove AE equals to EC. Let me solve it like this. No problem. AE equals to EC. So now let us go to proof. Very easy proof. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. So by basic proportionality theorem, I can write AD by DB equals to AE by EC. AD by DB equals to AE by EC. Okay. So you see, AD by, in place of DB, I can write AD. Okay, I'll give you the reason why I am writing this one. AE by EC. You write, since D is the midpoint, of AB, so therefore what will be? AD will be equals to DB. Okay, so what I have written? So AD by DB it is given, but D is the midpoint, that means this part and this part it is equal. So if it is equal, then I can write AD by AD equals to AE by EC. So after that only two line. AD by AD means 1 by 1. Okay. And there it is AE by EC. So if I do cross multiply, then it will be EC equals to AE. So if EC equals to AE, that means E bisects AC. Then E bisects AC. Finished. Okay. Now let us move to next question. Question number 8. Using theorem 6.2 to prove that the line joining the midpoint of any two side of a triangle is parallel to the third side. Okay, now earlier theorem, using this one you have to prove that the line joining the midpoint of two side of a triangle is parallel to the third side. So just the opposite of this one you have to prove. Here we have proved that from the midpoint if I draw a line, then this line also bisects this one. Now it is given that if these two lines are drawn, if D and D are the midpoints, then you have to prove that this one is parallel to this one. Same thing, same question. Okay. So similarly, same question number 8 you write. Just you have to converse and you have to prove it. You write, let ABC be a triangle. Let ABC be a triangle in which D and E are the midpoint, in which D and E are the midpoints of side, which one? AB and AC. So what you want to prove? Okay, right, AB and AC respectively, right? AB and AC respectively. What you want to prove? You want to prove that DE is parallel to BC. DE is parallel to BC. So now you go on for writing proof. Same like earlier. So what is, since D and E are the midpoints, okay, let me write like this. Since D and E are the midpoint of the side AB and AC, since D and E are the midpoints of the side AB and AC respectively, so I can say that AD is equals to BD, AD is equals to BD, and AE is equals to EC. I can say, no, if this is the midpoint, that means this one and this one equal, and this side equal. So if these two are equal, okay, so I can write like this. Since AD by BD, if I go on doing the divide, what the answer I will get? I will get 1, and AE by EC also, if I do the divide, then what I am getting? 1. So what we know that if the ratio comes the same for both, then we can say that they are parallel. If you could recall the second theorem of this, that if the ratio is same, then we can say that the lines are parallel. Theorem 2, what we have read, that if the ratio is same, that means if you just recall question number 2, what we have solved there, the question was given like this, that E and EF are the points on the dot, and you want to check whether they are parallel or not. So what we have done, we have just simply taken out the ratio of the side. If it is equal, then we have said that yes, the lines are parallel. So here also you see AD by BD is equals to 1, AE by EC also equals to 1. So from these two I can write AD by BD, the ratio is same for both AE by EC. So if the ratio is same, then we can say that DE is parallel to BC. So after that you write, therefore DE is parallel to, after writing, okay, let me write here, after writing this one you write, therefore DE is parallel to BC, and reason you write, it will be the converse of the basic proportionality theorem. You write converse of basic proportionality theorem, not that theorem, no, but that was the converse of basic proportionality theorem. It was like this, that if the ratio is same, then we can say that the lines are parallel. Okay, so now let us move to question number 9. Question number 9, what is given? You see ABC is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to CD, AB is parallel to DC, and its diagonal intersect each other at point O. So that AO by BO equals to CO by DO, AO by BO equals to CO by DO. 8 and 9 are also same, question number 9 and 10 are also same. Just you see that you are to prove, one, you are to prove that AO by BO equals to CO by BO, and another one, just the opposite one, you are to show that it is a trapezium if it is AO by BO equals to CO by DO. Okay, so first of all let us solve first one, then we'll go for the next one. So question number 9, figure, so it is not there. Okay, let me draw ABCD given a trapezium. Actually we need to divide it into two triangles, then only we can one thing let us do, it will be easy for us to solve. Let me take a line parallel to them. Okay. Okay, let me take a line parallel to them which passes through the, but it is given like this, no, the point of intersection, no. So question is to, question is given, if you read the question carefully, that AB and CD are a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC, and the diagonals intersect each other at point O. diagonals intersect at each other at point O. So it will be like a construction. We'll draw EF parallel to this one, because by using this one we can see solve it very nicely. So you see what is given. Let me write. Given ABCD is a trapezium. Given ABCD is a trapezium in which the diagonal AC, in which the diagonal AC and BD intersect, in which the diagonal AC and BD intersect each other at point O, So it is there in the question. So you have to prove that. To prove, AO by BO equals to CO by DO. AO by BO equals to CO by O. No problem. We will prove it. AO by BO equals to CO by DO. So for this purpose, I am drawing a construction. What is it? By dotted line, you can see EF. So EF will be parallel to DC also and parallel to AB also. So construction you write. Draw EF, which is parallel to DC also and parallel to AB also. It is parallel to DC also and parallel to AC also, and meeting AD and CB at meeting AD at, okay. I'll take only this part, so I'm not going for that one. So meeting AD at E. So if this one meet AD at E, so now if I take triangle ABD, if I take this triangle, then what will happen? This one is parallel to this one, this triangle. So I can write that this side is equal to this one, that one is equal to this one. Can I write it? It will be DO by OB equals to this DE by AE or EA. So proof. Okay, let me write it from there. After up to this much, it is okay. So proof now I am doing. In triangle ADB, EF is parallel to AB. That means EF means I can write it as OE also, no? Same thing, so parallel. So OE is parallel to AB. So if OE is parallel to OB, so by BPT I can write, by basic proportionality theorem I can write DE by EA equals to DO by OB. DE by EA equals to DO by OB. And again I will take the other one. And now in triangle CDA, now what I am doing, I am taking this triangle CDA. In triangle CDA, actually I want to keep them on the same one, okay. So in triangle CDA, what is it? OE is parallel to CD. One time I am taking this one and this one parallel. Another time I am taking this one and that one parallel. So OE is parallel to CD. So by BPT, if I just go on solving all, no, then I will not be able to find. So I don't need the other. If I just can show that this one and this one, and there this one and that one, then I will get one one side common like this, like earlier. Then I can relate and I can write. Okay. So OE is parallel to CD. So if OE is parallel to CD, then DE by EA will be equals to OC by OA. DE by, actually I am seeing this one and writing DE by EA, this side by this side will be equals to OC by OA. So let me give it as Roman number. So DE by EA equals to OC by OA. So from 1 and 2 I can write this one common. So that means DO by OB equals to OC by OA. DO by OB equals to OC by OA. So if you see the question, what you have to prove? I have to prove AO by BO equals to CO by DO. So you see here, DO it is there, OA it is there. So let me change. Okay, let me first of all arrange them. Let me make them how it is there in the question. So DO, BO and OB and BO it is same. OC and CO it is same, and DO AO. So now you see, if I just interchange them, it will be okay. So if I just interchange them, so OA comes, AO comes here, so it will be AO, and DO will AO by BO, it will be equals to CO by DO. Just you see, I have just interchanged them, okay. So AO came here, DO went there, so AO by BO equals to CO by DO. Okay, so now the last question. So we have proved this one. So now the last question of this exercise, what is it? It is that the diagonals of a quadrilateral ABCD intersect each other at point O such that AO by BO equals to CO by, which one we have proved? Now you have to utilize this one and you have to find that ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium. Okay. Just the converse of this one you have to use it. Question number 10. So like earlier I have to draw a trapezium, so I will draw it. Question is to prove that ABCD is a trapezium. So you see here, this part no need, okay, and up to this one U. So you see what is there. It is given that the diagonals of a quadrilateral ABCD intersect each other at point O. They intersect each other at point O such that AO by BO equals to CO by DO. So that ABCD is a trapezium. So first of all, what is given? We will write this one. Given ABCD is a quadrilateral. And what are the things given? That the diagonals intersect each other at O. ABCD is a quadrilateral whose diagonals AC and BD intersect, AC and BD intersect each other at O. Okay. So now you see, this is there in the question given, and another one it is given that AO by BO equals to CO by DO. Write like this, such that AO by BO equals to CO by DO. It is there in the question. So we have to prove that ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a quadrilateral. ABCD is a trapezium. Thank you. we have to prove that quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. So now what we are going to do, for that purpose we need a construction. So I have drawn it one drawn it. So I will write EO, EO is parallel to AB also and parallel to DC also. So construction, draw EO parallel to AB or BA, you can write. Draw EO parallel to AB meeting AD at E. Like earlier, okay. So draw EO parallel to AB. I don't need this part, so I have not extended this one. How much I need, that much I have given. So EO parallel to AB meeting AD at E. So now you see, I will go to proof. Normally how we are doing, I will just do in that way. So now what we will do, like earlier I will take triangle AB, yes, ABD. In triangle ABD we have EO is parallel to AB. In triangle ABD we have EO is parallel to AB. So I can write, by basic proportionality theorem, I can write, what is it? This one is ABD, this triangle is proportional to this one. That means this one will be equal to this side will be equal to, the ratio will be same. So I can write it like this, DE by EA equals to DE by EA equals to EO by OB. So DE by EA equals to DO by OB. By basic proportionality theorem. But you see what we have written earlier, it is given that AO by BO equals to CO by DO. It is given in the question, it is given, you see here, what is written here, AO by BO equals to CO by DO. Make it like this so that it looks similar. So DO by BO, no, okay, so let me interchange them. If I interchange them, then this part and that part will be same, no? So DO by BO, and there it will be CO by AO, nothing, just I have interchanged them, okay. So now this part became equals to that one, okay. Now I can relate them and I can write that DE by EA equals to CO by AO. From 1 and 2, when you give equation number 2, so I can write DE by EA equals to CO by AO. DE by EA equals to CO by AO. Okay. Now you see here, DE by EA, DE which one? This one, by EA equals to CO by AO, CO which one? This one, by AO, this one, okay. So this side is equals to this one and this side is equals to this one, okay. So I can see that this line is parallel to this one also, this line is parallel to that one also. So I will write like this. EO is parallel to DC. So if this one equals to that one, so I can write, what is it? EO is parallel to DC also. EO is parallel to DC because you can write here by the converse of basic proportionality theorem. I can write EO is EO parallel to DC. Just now I have shown. Now you see here, after finding, what you have got? DE by EA equals to
CO by DO. That means I am talking about this triangle. So that means this one is parallel to that one. So EO is parallel to DC. So by basic proportionality theorem. Okay. But earlier though we have given no EO is a parallel to EO is parallel to AB. So if EO is parallel to DC also, EO is parallel to AB also, then I can write that this AB and DC are parallel. AB is parallel to DC.
We know that if two sides are equal to one another, then if like this parallel lines are given, if this one is parallel to this one and this one is parallel to that one, that means I can say that these two are also parallel. So here this line is parallel to this line is parallel to this one, that means these two lines are also parallel. Okay, so these two lines are also parallel. That means AB is parallel to DC. AB is parallel to DC. So you can write that hence ABCD is a trapezium. Hence ABCD is a trapezium. Okay. If this thing AB in place of AB it is written CD, then okay, no problem is there. I forgot what I wrote in proof part. So just proof to I have written to prove that ABCD is a trapezium. No, then no problem is there. It's okay. So what I have said that this line is parallel to this line is parallel to that one, that means these two are also parallel to one another, and if these two are parallel, that means it is a trapezium. It is a trapezium. APCD is a trapezium. Okay. Now you see example number 2 and 3. Now I will discuss this one, and class will be over after that. So example number 2, you see ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC, and E and F are the non-parallel sides, AD and BC respectively, such that EF is parallel to AB. So for this one, what they have done, just given a small construction. So after that, these two triangles became same. So ADE, ADC, if you see triangle ADC, what is there? EG is parallel to DC. So basic proportionality theorem you can use here. AE by ED equals to AG by GC. Again, similarly, if I take the other one, that is CAB, CAB also, there also I am getting that CG is CG by AG equals to CF by FB. So that means by comparing both, I can write that AB is parallel to ED and BF is parallel to FC. So simple thing, how we have done, so many sum we have done, so same like this one. You see example number 3 also, it is also same. Here you see two lines are given in figure PS and PS and SQ is equals to PT by TR and PST is equals to PRQ. Prove that PQR is an isosceles triangle. You have to prove that PQR is an isosceles triangle. So you see the triangle here, PS by SQ equals to PT by TR. Okay, it is given here in the question. So since ST is parallel to QR, if two lines are parallel, so here corresponding angles are given. You see very carefully, they are like this. If two lines are parallel, then the corresponding angles S and there it is Q. No, if you see that triangle, it was like this. So these two are this corresponding angles. And again from this side also, these two are corresponding angles. So first one, you see angle PST is equals to angle PQR, given corresponding angle. In other one also, PST is equals to PRO. The PST equals to PRO, it is PST equals to PRO, it is PRQ, it is given in the question. Okay. So one I have taken by corresponding angle, another one it was given. So if I just compare them, one is equals to PST equals to PQR. For one we have got PST equals to PQR, and it is given in the question that PST equals to PRQ. PST equals to PRQ. PST equals to PQR. We have got this one from corresponding angle, and this one it was given. So now if you see that PST, PST to common, that means angle PQR is equals to angle PRQ. PRQ. So if you see the triangle carefully, triangle is like this, and you have to prove that it is isosceles. So triangle, if you see, it is like this, PST and there Q and there it is C. Okay. So if you see the triangle, it is like this, and what we have just now, we have found that PQR is equals to PQR, that means this angle is equals to PR, PQR, and equals PQR is equals to angle PRQ. PQR is equals to angle PRQ. So we have proved that this angle is equals to this one. And if this we have read this thing in earlier class also, that if these two angles are base angles are equal, that means the side are also equal. That means PQ is equals to PR. We know that if the base angle in a triangle, if the these two angles are equal, then their opposite sides are also equal. So PQ equals to PR. And if PQ is equals to PR, that means in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then we can say that the triangle is an isosceles triangle. Okay. So this is the end of today's class. If you have any doubt regarding any question, you can call me at night. Thank you.